Welcome to this video on analyzing CRISPR editing results with Geneious Prime. The Analyze CRISPR Editing Results tool uses unaligned Illumina sequencing reads from imported FASTQ files. If your reads are paired, you must merge them before running the analysis. Refer to the video on merging paired reads to learn how to do this. I will use a file containing merged paired reads for this video. You will also require a reference sequence file to run the Analyze CRISPR Editing Results tool. The reference sequence should be a short sequence spanning the CRISPR editing site of similar length to the reads, typically the unedited amplicon sequence. Select this reference sequence and the file containing your sequencing reads. Go to Annotate and Predict and select Analyze CRISPR Editing Results. Geneious should automatically set the reference sequence. However, you can also use the drop-down menu or the Choose button to specify the reference sequence. The Variants of Interest section allows you to specify how far upstream and downstream of the CRISPR cleavage site to look for variants. You can also adjust the minimum variant frequency. This setting determines the minimum frequency of variants included in the results, and it allows you to set the translation frame to use if your reference sequence does not have a coding sequence annotation. Finally, you can adjust how Geneious handles sequencing errors. For example, when using a value of 0, the reads will combine into a single cluster, known as collapsed, if there is a greater than 50% chance that the variant is due to a sequencing error. To learn more, open the Help window. When you're happy with the settings, click OK to run the analysis. After the analysis has finished, Geneious will create an alignment file. This file is similar to the output from a map to reference, but instead of showing each read aligned to the reference, only one representative of each identical cluster is aligned. Each aligned sequence is named as follows: variant frequency, followed by the variant effect, and in parentheses, the total number of reads in cluster and the number of reads with putative sequencing errors in cluster. By switching to the Info tab, you can see the overall results for the output, including the percentage of reads with no variant versus the percentage of reads with knockout variants. To view the results in tabular format, switch to the Annotations tab and select the variant type. You can use the Columns drop-down menu to adjust the data shown in the table, or export the Annotations table as a CSV file by selecting Export Table. And that's how you can analyze CRISPR editing results in Geneious Prime. To learn more, visit geneious.com.